Hi, and welcome to Data Science Wednesday. My name is Tessa Jones, and I'm a data scientist from Decisive Data. Today we're going to be talking about different types of data science questions. And the whole objective of this video is to give you an idea of how data scientists think about different questions. The first topic we're going to talk about is exploratory questions. This should sound somewhat familiar to you if you watch some of our other videos, because we did a whole section on exploratory analysis. The whole point of this relative to data science is to get an idea of what your data looks like or what it can provide you for future work, to really kind of shape or profile your data. So one question we might ask is, how are our variables distributed? So one way to think about this is, if we are a hardware store and we sell brooms, we want to know how many brooms we have in each store, because this gives us an idea of how to move forward with the solutions we might provide. Another thing we want to know is how things are correlated. So if we have dust storms that happen in the x-axis, and we have an increase in broom sales, then we see here from this line, based on how it's plotted, that they're correlated. So we sell more brooms when we have dust storms, which is kind of cool to know and also important to incorporate when we're defining methodologies for data science questions. Another thing we might notice, if we say we're really excited about these brooms, and we decide to plot the bristle length along the handle length, and we happen to notice that different regions buy certain types of brooms. So in this region, they might like the short bristles and the short handles, whereas in the red group, they might like the long bristles and the short handles, so on and so forth, which is another good data point to have to incorporate into a methodology to answer a data science question. So that's a general idea for exploratory type questions. Another one is inferential questions. So this is all about trying to extrapolate or understand a larger population based on what we discover about a smaller population. And in this form of question, it's really important to have a good subpopulation that properly represents what you want to get out of the larger population. Another really important thing to understand is, whatever conclusions you make or assumptions you have about this population, you really need to have a good idea of the level of uncertainty that you have. Because if you're mildly uncertain in your subpopulation, when you apply that to the bigger population, that uncertainty just grows. So you really need to be careful about uncertainty. To give you a little bit of an example of what this might look like, let's say that you're a company that's interested in finding new partners. So you take a subpopulation of partners that you know are really good, and you put it through a system where you figure out what makes partners good. You really define that. Then you go to the bigger population and say, okay, extract all the partners that have those same traits and values. And then you can say, okay, these are the people that I want to be partners with. So that's an example of inferential type questions. So the next question is predictive, and this should be somewhat familiar to you because we've talked about it several times before, and I think it's also a very attainable type of question because a lot of business people want to know what's going to happen in the future, which is what predictive questions are really all about. And if you've watched any of our previous videos, the example we really use a lot is around retail and sales. So how can we predict sales moving forward? If we want to know how our sales of brooms is going to be moving forward for a given store, we would use a predictive solution, or we would have a predictive question. So in this example, we have historical broom sales, and then this is today. And then the predictive question would be like, what is it going to be in the future? So that takes us to causal. And I would like to introduce you to Fire Dude. Fire Dude is the effect of something. What is it the effect of? We know that it's the effect of heat, fuel, and oxygen. If we take away fuel, Fire Dude's gone. But we really like Fire Dude, so we'll keep fuel here for now. So this is a pretty idealistic view of what causal is. In reality, usually there's an unknown number of causes for a particular effect. Not only are there an unknown number of causes, we also don't know how much they impact the effect. If we take away one cause, it might minimally impact the effect. If we take away a different cause, it might have a huge impact on the effect. Point being that this is a huge puzzle to solve, and it's very complicated to identify not only what your causes are, how many you have, but also what impact it actually has on the effect. So this one is very important and really powerful in helping to drive action for business people, but it's also very difficult to attain. So that's generally a good mix of what kind of data science questions we generally tackle. As a data scientist, we have exploratory, inferential, predictive, and causal. That's Data Science Wednesday, and we really appreciate you watching. Have a good day.